So first number is the name of our company. Our company was established after seeing a positive potential in the agriculture and food industry. The product that our company provide are mushroom kit that is edible to eat. This sparked the idea that we want everyone, both adult and children, to participate in agriculture by growing their own mushroom. Our company's main operation are to create, provide, sell and supply mushroom kit to individuals of all ages. Our company use 3 levels of management and there are 3 skills required by this manager. Firstly, the top managers. In our company, the top managers establish the organization goals, policy and strategy as well as making long-term decisions. For example, chief executive officer. The skills that our top manager use is conceptual skill. Conceptual skills are important for them because they are responsible for the overall management of the company. Next, middle managers. Middle managers will function to interpret top management directive into operating plans and make implementation decisions. The example of middle managers in our company including financial manager and marketing manager. These middle managers use human skill. Human skill include having the ability to motivate, understand, lead and communicate well with other people. Last but not least, first line managers. They are responsible to direct and support work on non-managerial personnel and make short-term decisions. For example, clerk and market analysis. The skill involved from this manager is technical skill. Technical skill are an ability to use the procedures, technique and knowledge of a specialized field.
Supan has a very big plan in achieving the desired goal of opening more stores worldwide. Supan plans to open more stores since it is simple for all clients to purchase our product. Therefore, can know the features that can be improved to provide comprehensive satisfaction to consumers worldwide and can know the interests of theirs, which it is the main target of our company that can lead into creating the new innovation of our product time by time. This can put Supan as the most popular brand among the world because our product mushroom kit is very user-friendly. Vision. The vision of our company is to bring inspiration and innovation to every consumer in the world. Mission. The mission of our company, firstly, is to introduce our products to every consumer around the world. Secondly, to create a positive atmosphere and a feeling of love everywhere. Lastly, to make everyone love mushrooms and can have fun while growing mushrooms together. Types of plan. Number 1. Standing plan. Firstly, policies. Supan policies is to set a very hard standard in the manufacture of Supan products that have been designed. They have been given guidelines in handling problems that occur in trade, manufacturing, or common issues. Secondly, procedure. To ensure our products are fresh and are undamaged, every employee will be observed at all working hours while processing the mushroom kit, fittings preferably so that every buyer feels satisfied with the quality of our company's products. Thirdly, rules. Every employer should adhere to the ethics and rules that have been set in order to achieve the company's objective. Number 2. Single-use plan. First and last is project. Supan are planning to organize a program that allows mushroom kits to be available now to the public. Our product that are exactly user-friendly could impress everyone even sitting in the interior as it is not as complicated as requiring technology or too modern according to globalization.
Organizing is the process to determine what tasks that need to be done, how tasks we manage, and who are responsible for the works. The developing of organizational is must, and it must be in an organizational structure. Organizational structure is a system which the outlines are how to organize certain activities managed by the managers in order to achieve the goals of the organization. So, our company uses the lean structure because this flat structure can maintain the power and prestige of the major functions and also can boost self-esteem among the managers. The benefits of this structure are we can easily supervise our employee and we are approachable if they need something to ask or to discuss. The last but not the least, we can also share our thought and listen about other solutions if we are facing problems in our business. This will bring many benefits rather than just participating in the meeting but not letting employees to give their solutions.
Decision making is the process through which managers identify and resolve problems and capitalize on opportunities. In our company, we have applied 2 types of decision making, which are program decision and non-program decision. A program decision is a structured and repetitive decision that can be handled by the routine approach. For example, when a customer has a complaint about a product or service, so our manager decided to have a rules and regulation in order to protect the company. Some of the rules and regulation in our company are every employee, whether behind the scene or who serve the customer, must examine condition of the product before reaching the customer to avoid another complaint. The non-program decision is when the unique unusual or exceptional problems. It is unstructured and require management at a higher level. The problem we face is that our product are not sold within the set of time period because the world is in a state of pandemic due to COVID-19 which prevent customers from visiting our store. So our manager decided to only allow customers to place order through our online website to make things easier for them, and then the product will be delivered to their front door.
We consider the motivational elements used in administrative management for employees of Sohan Company. Motivation is a drive only that we desire a change either ourselves or the environment. We apply the Herzberg two model theory. Mostly, we practice and also provided the essential that are required. There are two factors content that we use, which is motivation factors and hygiene factors. We emphasize that motivation factors affected most of their performance. It consists of progress in achievement job performance, opportunities to achieve advancements, and recognition their best performance by giving rewards and praises. For hygiene factors, we provided a comfortable workspace and facilities like air conditioner, pantry, and dining room. Most crucial things are every employee should know and apply policy and rules to avoid unwanted things happen and work being well. The atmosphere of relationship between owner, managing staff, and employee are good, such as respecting and supporting each other.
What is a leader? Leaders distinguish themselves by their talents to imagine, encourage, strategize, and assist their employees towards success, regardless of recognition or position in a firm. They are more than just managers. They are innovators who encourage others to join them on their quest for a better vision. They also understand that there is always opportunity for improvement in their leadership abilities, ideas, and production. Therefore, they rely on mutual support from their team members. Leadership, on the other hand, is the ability that aids the promotion of proper individuals and the maintenance of a cohesive work environment. A single definition of organizational leadership may keep everyone on the same page and help develop certain types of leaders for the future. Organizations must also use leadership filters to guarantee that the right people are placed in the positions of leadership. If an organization's common leadership definition revolves around humble leaders working as servants, this drives the leadership filter and ensures that leaders who fulfill those traits are developed and promoted. Situational leadership is the leadership approach that Sohan uses. It is a model developed by Kenneth Pankhart and Paul Hersey, and it is a type of adaptive type of leadership, and it depends on which type of leadership and strategies are best suited to common goals and vision. Adaptability is one of the keys of situational leadership. As a reflection of our willing and able a follower is to complete a task, Hershey and Blanchard have identified four stages of readiness. 1. A follower is both unable and unwilling to do a job. 2. A follower is unable to do the job but willing to perform necessary tasks. 3. A follower is able to do the job but unwilling to be told what to do. 4. A follower is both able and willing to do the job. A situational leader in Sohan should work with one of the following leadership behavioral styles depending on four stages of readiness level. First of all, talent. The objective of this style is to create movement. Leaders with a talent style may make all choices and then express them to the team. Second of all, selling. The objective of the selling is to create buy-in and understanding. When a follower is unable to do the job but is willing to perform necessary tasks, this sort of leadership is often applied in Sohan. Third, participating. The objective of this style is to create alignment. In Sohan, the leaders of course offers less directions and allow members of the group to take a more active role in coming up with ideas and making decisions. And last but not least, delegating. The objective of this style is to enhance task mastery and autonomy. The majority of choices are made by group members and they bear the majority of the blame for what happens in a group.
Controlling. What is control? Control is a process to ensure that plans are carried accordingly and the final objectives are achieved. Controlling, on the other hand, is manager's responsibility to control. For example, by setting prior target, generate ideas to realize company's aim and give instruction to the staffs. Secondly, management and labor commitment, which means an organizational cultural design by management. In Sohan, the manager is responsible to construct rules and regulations so that our business can run smoothly and systematically. Firstly, preventive control. We take preventive control seriously as we want to make sure that the workers can have a conducive and friendly working environment without neglecting their works. For example, Sohan conducts meeting twice a week to share creative ideas and to improve any potential proposal in order to gain and maintain support from one another. Besides that, we also form a company's website where we provide information regarding our products, and we also enable comments and critiques from both the workers and their customers, as we want to get the genuine response to allow us to improve our business. Secondly, management and labor commitment, which means an organizational cultural design by management. In Sohan, the manager is responsible to construct rules and regulations so that our business can run smoothly and systematically. Lastly, corrective control. It is important to ensure that all the crucial pieces of information regarding our company are kept well and obeyed. We record all informal and required business procedures to refer to when needed. Then we also use it to inform to let our new staff know all the basic things that they need to know. Besides that, we also provide, we also construct rules to be to enable us to discipline ourselves without becoming too without becoming too much selfish or self-centered in our when conducting our business. Definition: what is quality? Quality is all the tasks that have been done. TQM stands for Total Quality Management. On the other hand, is a well-planned strategy to establish a company. It is vital to enhance employees' credibility and encourage teamwork. Tools for global competition. Firstly, customer-driven standards that includes external customer and internal customer. Internal customer means the supplier is not a part of organization, while external customer means the supplier is a part of an organization. In Supan, we choose to use internal customer methods. It enables the employees to become more aware of our products, and if should be any problem arise, they could easily the problem could easily be handled, easily settled within our organization itself. Secondly, management and labor commitment, which means an organizational cultural design by management. In Supan, the manager is responsible to construct rules and regulations so that our business can run smoothly and systematically. Thirdly, organization and coordination of effects that is divided into benchmarking and Kaizen. Supan applies benchmarking methods to widen our views and to improve our company by comparing our business with other successful or leading companies. Number four, employee participation that includes quality circle and special purpose team. Supan applies both types of group discussion in order to maintain and to tackle problems that arise accordingly. Lastly, fishbone diagram and benchmarking. Fishbone or Ishikawa diagram is a diagram of potential reasons to a problem that is visually expressed, while benchmarking is a process to find the best products, features, processes or services available and use them to boost our company's ability. We choose benchmarking methods by brainstorming ideas and keep on challenging ourselves and our staff to come up with better solutions or any better creative and more innovative ideas.